Even though it's literally my full-time job, I try not to follow casting news for upcoming comic book TV shows and movies because I don't want to have any biases coming in that influence my opinions. But when I saw episode 1 of Hawkeye and this dude came on screen, I audibly groaned, causing my girlfriend to roll her eyes, pause the show, and let me do my thing, ramble out the complete history of the character in the comics. So this is Jacques Duquesne, and in the comics, he's known as the Swordsman. This guy is a part of one of my least favorite storylines of all time, which gets pretty fucking weird. So good news, you're my girlfriend now, because you get to hear me talk all about him. But before we hop too far into things, I need to give a quick thank you to one of my recurring sponsors, Keeps. As you've no doubt heard by now, 2 out of 3 guys will experience some form of male pattern baldness by the time they turn 35, which is where Keeps comes in. They're a subscription service that uses generic versions of FDA-approved medications for hair loss to make it easy and affordable to treat male pattern baldness. By working with a real licensed doctor over the internet, you can get the right treatment for you mailed directly to your door every 3 months, eliminating the need for boring pharmacy pickups or doctor visits. But if you ever need to check in with your doctor with questions or concerns, then you can message them 24/7. If you're ready to take action and prevent hair loss, then go to keeps.com/comicdrake, or click the link in the description down below to receive 50% off your first order. That's keeps.com/comicdrake. Thank you very much, Keeps, but now let's get back to the video. The Swordsman made his first appearance in Avengers number 19 in 1965, and was created by Stan Lee and Don Heck. He's from the fictional country of Sin Kong, a French colony in Central Asia, and he's the son of a government official. Now, the Duquesnes are descendants of a legendary hero called the Crimson Cavalier, and on his 18th birthday, Jacques' father gave him a family heirloom, the Cavalier Sword, which initially he wasn't all that excited about. Well, many of the native inhabitants of Sin Kong were treated as slaves, which made Jacques very uncomfortable, prompting him to work with an underground resistance movement and take up both the sword and costumed identity of the Swordsman. For years, Swordsmen fought side by side with the revolutionaries, helping them win battle after battle. Despite being one of the colonizers they were working to liberate themselves from, Duquesne earned the respect of his fellow rebels. But once they finally won their freedom, Jacques was no longer needed, and they turned on him because they didn't, quote, owe anything to a French dog, even one who was stupid enough to fight on their side. Using his combat skills, Duquesne managed to escape to America and put his mastery of the blade to use as a carnival performer. Years later, two brothers named Clint and Barney Barton ran away to the circus from their abusive foster dad, and they were found by Jacques, who stood up for them when said abuser came looking for the boys. After scaring off their foster dad, Duquesne invited the Bartons to join the circus, and instilled within them very, very valuable skills. Jacques taught Clint the ways of the blade and bow, giving him the nickname Hawkeye, and he also gave him his prized possession, his father's knife. Barney, on the other hand, was too old to start training, so instead, Swordsman taught him how to steal, which made Clint very uncomfortable. One day, however, Clint caught Jacques stealing from the circus itself and was appalled. Now, Duquesne tried to convince Clint to join him, but instead, they fought. At this point, the student could not surpass the master, so Swordsman defeated Barton and left him for dead. Afterwards, Jacques skipped town and committed crimes all over the world. Though this life of debauchery wasn't enough for Duquesne, and eventually he tried to join the Avengers, hoping to use membership there as a cover to pull off even bigger schemes. Although his criminal record was very easy to look up, it wasn't a terrible idea. I mean, just 3 issues earlier, the roster had a massive shakeup, with it now only consisting of Captain America and 3 former villains, Scarlet Witch, Quicksilver, and Hawkeye. But Jacques went about it in the stupidest way possible, because he took Captain America hostage and tried to force them to make him their leader. Obviously, that didn't work out, but in the middle of the fight, Swordsman was teleported away by the Mandarin, who enlisted him to fight the Avengers, even though he was literally in the middle of doing just that. Not only did the Mandarin soup up Duquesne's sword with all sorts of new tricks and powers, but he made a lifelike hologram of Iron Man that appeared before the Avengers to say, "What the hell? Why are you guys fighting the Swordsman? I told him that he could be an Avenger. He was just trying to show off how strong he was." Captain America was like, "Well, I have no need for further proof. Your word is good enough, old chum." And so holographic Iron Man poofed away, and Swordsman was teleported back in to be all, "And now you know why I dropped in." Despite how weird and clearly sketchy all this was, the Swordsman was admitted to the team on the spot, and now that he had insider access, the Mandarin wanted Duquesne to blow up the Avengers with a bomb. But since Jacques didn't think that was very sportsmanlike, and because he thought the Scarlet Witch was pretty hot, and I mean, he's not wrong, he disarmed the bomb. However, Captain America walked in at just the wrong time and assumed that Duquesne was actually planting it. So they fought, and that was the end of that. After this failure, Swordsman went back to performing shows to earn a living, but he would pop in every now and then as a reoccurring antagonist to the Avengers. But it's nothing too special. Yet after losing time and time again, Jacques became a self-loathing drunkard, drinking away his problems in much the same way that I do after reading the comments section of a video where I say, hey, diversity is cool, actually. While he was wasting away in Margaritaville, Swordsman was found by a woman named Mantis, who helped get him back on his feet and became his lover. Alright, so as I'm about to explain, Mantis is a ridiculous character that I have a whole video about, and she got Swordsman wrapped up in some of the dumbest stuff that I have ever read. And believe me, I have read a ton of dumb comics. So now that he's hooked up with Mantis, Swordsman was able to convince the Avengers to give him a second chance by letting him and his new girlfriend join the team. Although Swordsman is a tough combatant with that powered up sword and he taught Hawkeye almost everything he knows, Jacques was mostly brought aboard because the writer of the book, Steve Englehart, is absolutely obsessed with Mantis, and he made her the center of the comic for a good while, because apparently she is the Celestial Madonna, a perfect being that's prophesied to give birth to the Celestial Messiah. During this time, Swordsman was still full of angst and self-doubt, which was made worse because his girlfriend Mantis was super into the Vision, and she tried her best to break up him and the Scarlet Witch. The epitome of this can be seen here when Mantis and Duquesne are making out, and she's just staring down Vision the entire time. Despite Mantis straight up telling Jacques that she was no longer in love with him, the Swordsman still fought tooth and nail for her when Kang the Conqueror showed up to kidnap Mantis in hopes of forcing himself to become the father of the Celestial Messiah. Yes, that's sexual assault. I hate the storyline with a passion, with its multiple versions of Kangs and the overly convoluted shenanigans that it entails, but it ended up with the Conqueror deciding that if he can't be the Messiah's father, then nobody can. So he tried to kill Mantis, but Jacques jumped in the way of the blast and was killed instead, becoming the first Avenger to die in the line of duty. Alright, so are you ready for the weird shit? So almost immediately, Swordsman sort of came back to life, because there's these alien tree people called the Kotati, and they were sent to Earth since their eldest being was the prophesized father of the Celestial Messiah. This old tree dude merged with Swordsman's dying body and was like, hey baby, let's pollinate. And Mantis was totally into it. And since Vision had just proposed to Scarlet Witch, it was decided that there was going to be a double-sized Avengers wedding, even though Mantis was playing homewrecker with them this entire time. Anyway, the Swordsman slash Tree Dude hybrid and Mantis got married, they left their physical bodies behind, and the two of them went off to space to have soul sex. After their spirits intermingled, Mantis made a new plant body for herself to give birth to their child, Sequoia, and the new Swordsman consciousness returned to its body back on Earth, where it remained in suspended animation inside of his grave. All of this sentience entering and exiting and the constant growing and regrowing of bodies ended up giving Mantis amnesia. So when she went back to Earth and visited Duquesne's grave, he rose from the ground and killed Mantis in order for her mind to return to her original body, which also apparently made her get all of her memories back, because comics. With his duty done, Jacques gave his sword to Hawkeye, disintegrated, and fucked off to his homeworld to grow a brand new plant body and raise his son. Yet despite being a highly respected Kotati elder and the father of the Celestial Messiah, the plant swordsman wasn't allowed back into the grove as he was now too human. This alienated Jacques, and he returned back to Earth for the self-imposed exile by merging with his original tree form. But when the forest was being chopped down, he separated once again and slaughtered everyone in sight in berserker's rage. Sequoia witnessed all of this, and fueled by his father's rage, they vowed to eradicate all animal life in the galaxy. This kicked off a whole interstellar war with twists and turns, but if we're going to be completely honest, it was Sequoia that did the bulk of the work. All his father did was whisper in his son's ear to egg on the war and mope about how he stuck with Jacques Duquesne's memories and personalities. I mean, hell, he was never really all that invested in the war in the first place and was just looking out for his own self-interest. And when the Kotati clearly were losing, Swordsman took his own son hostage and threatened his life in an attempt to save his own. But since Black Panther was unmoved by this, T'Challa just ripped him to shreds. The Swordsman is an all-over-the-place character, but he is really interesting and compelling as the mentor and father figure to Hawkeye. He was never really all that special as a villain, and he probably just should have stayed as a low-level bad guy. As an Avenger, he was basically useless. He didn't have any powers, and his sword wasn't a cool enough gadget to carry him like Hawkeye. He He also didn't have much agency in his own right, more or less just being used as an accessory to Mantis to develop her plot. And if we're going to be completely honest, Jacques Duquesne's most redeeming quality is that oh-so-glorious mustache that I am very jealous of. In my opinion, this makes Swordsman one of the worst Avengers of all time, and I will totally admit that a lot of my disdain for him comes from how much I hate Mantis and the Celestial Madonna storyline, but that tree nonsense was just plain ridiculous and overcomplicates the character to the point of him being completely unenjoyable. But hey, if you enjoyed this video, then maybe consider subscribing or even watching another one. And if you like this, well, good news, I have all sorts of Hawkeye content that you might be interested in. Like maybe the video that I did on everyone who has ever been Ronin. It's pretty neat. But anyway, I hope you learned at least a little something new, and hopefully, I'll see you next time.